Hey guys, and welcome to Let's Play the Oregon Trail. Now, I've actually tried to record this once already, and it didn't work out too well. My voice kept skipping, and wait, the first thing I want to do is turn off the sound because the sound is annoying as hell, and you will not be hearing any of it anyway. I'm using Cam Studio to record this, and the Cam Studio voice recording software sucks. Anyway, we're choosing medium level difficulty, which is the Carpenter, and if you. Oh my God. See, I can't type in my full name here. So I will type in my initials, which spell out win. And next will be Sinclang. And no one else signed up, so we will be using character names. Cave Johnson. Carolyn. Oh, damn it, I did the same thing that I did last time. Sorry about that. And Chell. Yes, they are correct. And now we're going back to 1848. So anyway, and we will be leaving in April. Anyway, before leaving Independence, you should buy equipment and supplies. You have $800 in cash, but you don't have to spend it all now. You can buy whatever you need at Matt's General Store. All right, I'll explain what happened after this. Hello, I'm Matt. You're going to Oregon. I can fix you up with what you need. A team of oxen to pull your wagon, clothing for both summer and winter, plenty of food for the trip, ammunition for your rifles, and spare parts for your wagon. All right. So we'll start with oxen, and we want 3 yoke or 6 oxen. And next, food. I'm going to take the maximum amount of food I can get because I hate hunting in this game. Clothing. 10 sets of clothing. We're going to move right on to spare parts. 2 each. And then for ammunition, I will only take 10 boxes because I'm not. If I absolutely have to, I will, but I would prefer not to. Okay, and we will leave the store. Well, then you're ready to start. Good luck, and you have a long and difficult journey ahead of you. So I tried recording with the Cam Studio voice recording software, and my voice kept skipping, and it did not sound good at all. It was actually, if I were the one viewing it, I would be frustrated and not want to watch it. So I'm going to try this again with the sound recorder I have on my computer, not this Cam Studio one, and we are going to change our pace, and we are going to make it a strenuous pace but keep the rations filling. And let's go. Okay, I'm not going to read those. Those are just explaining what our next destination is, blah de blah de blah. No thanks. Yes. And look at that. Isn't that awful? And we have nothing to do here, so actually we're just going to continue on. Okay, Kansas River Crossing. You must cross the river in order to continue. The river at this point is currently 636 feet across and 5 feet 9 inches deep or 5.9 feet deep in the middle. I'm not quite sure which one that is. We are going to take the ferry, and I will tell you why. At one point, I mean, I had one that said, you're like 4.2 or 4 feet 2 inches in the middle, right? And wait for five. Okay, yeah, we'll do that. And so I decided to ford across. I mean, it's only 4 foot deep water. It's not horrible. Well, my thing overturns, and three people in my party drown. In 4 foot deep water. And I was just, yeah, it, that particular river hates me. So, yeah, I take the ferry, definitely. I'm gonna continue on. Would you like to look around? Yes, I will look around at every place I stop at so you guys can see this horrible, horrible graphic. These horrible graphics, yeah. I mean, don't get me wrong, I'm sure they were good for the time period, but I find them funny. Okay, you must cross the river. It's 235 feet across and 3 feet, roughly around 3 feet deep in the middle. So, you know what? I'm going to attempt to ford the river. Let's see what happens. Can I make it across? No! Caroline drowned! She drowned! Oh, crap. And I lost 2 oxen and a wagon wheel and 65 bullets. That's great. That's great. Let's just continue on. Okay. That was 3 feet deep water. And Carolyn drowned in 3 feet deep water. Okay. Yes. I don't know why there was only one gravestone put in the game. And yeah, huh. Cute. We're done. Just figured I'd show it to you guys. Yes, let's look around. That's Fort Kearney. And part of the fun of the Oregon Trail is talking to the people, so let's talk. Big Louie tells you the Platte River Valley forms a natural roadway from Fort Kearney to Fort Laramie. Travelers bound for California, Utah, and Oregon all take this road. Could be the easiest stretch of the whole trip. Should see antelope and plenty of buffalo. Okay. Let's continue. Okay. That's fine. Let's just get going. Okay, Chell has a broken arm. That's great. Chell is just going to have to make do with the broken arm. Yes. And we will rest for 2 days. There. Now let's continue on. Great. Oh, still 2 oxen? Are you freaking kidding me? I'm down to 2 oxen. Well, that's nice. Oh, okay. I have to continue. To continue the journey to Oregon, please flip to diskette. Please flip the diskette to side 2. Which, if we go down here, we just press this. Scroll back up. Line this back up. There. Yes. Let's take a look around. And we will buy supplies. 30 per ox. Damn. Alright, we'll just buy one more. Let's leave. And let's attempt a trade with someone that wants one axe, and he will trade you 27 pounds of food. Well, that doesn't sound like a bad deal. Let's try one more time. Oops, I pressed the wrong thing, I think. A woman traveler tells you, "Be warned, stranger, don't dig a water hole. Drink only river water. Salty as the plate plate, I'm not entirely sure how to pronounce that, sorry. River is, it's better than the cholera. We buried my husband last week. Could use some help with this harness if you can spare the time." Okay, let's try that again. Me another, I think that's supposed to be immigrant, who wants one wagon wheel. He will trade you one wagon axle. Sure, why not? There. That's better. I will try to trade someone an ox later. Wonderful. Cave has a fever. That's just great. He's gonna have to deal with the fever for a little bit. Great! Chell has a snake bite! That's wonderful. That's just wonderful. Found wild fruit. Bad water. Inadequate grass. Inadequate grass. I get it. More wild fruit. You are now at Independence Rock. Would you like to take a look around? Yes. Wonderful. Let's stop and rest for 2 days. And let's attempt a trade with someone. Who wants two wagon tongues? He will give you one ox. God, I really need another ox. Yes. See what else can trade one. Okay, yeah, no, I don't. All right, let's continue on. We've wasted enough time. Hopefully the wagon tongue doesn't break because I have no spares. Wild fruit. Inadequate grass. Very little water. Inadequate grass. Yes, let's look around. Okay. Let's attempt a trade. Wants a wagon, you will trade one. Oh, wait, it wasn't the axle, it was the wagon tongue that I need. No. Okay, there's no point in wasting time. Let's just go. The trail divides here. You may one head for the Green River crossing, or two head for the Fort Bridger. Head for Fort Bridger. I'm going to head for the Green River crossing, and even though I don't like crossing the rivers and everything, I'll tell you why. I went to Fort Bridger once, and well, that's great. And there was so much bad water and inadequate grass and stuff that my team was getting sick, and yes. Okay.